على محمد وآل محمد. يوم ذكريني من تمر زفة شباب من العرس محروم حنيتي دم المصاب شمعة شبابي من يطفوها حنيتي دم والجفن دار التراب يوم ذكريني من تمر زفة شباب إلك إلك يوم ذكريني يوم ذكريني من تمر من العرس محروم من العرس محروم حنيتي دم شمعة شبابي شمعة شباب من يطفوها من يطفوها حنيتي دم دار التراب يوم ذكري من تمر من ثد النيبة راضع بصاف الحليب وبهالشهادة صار لي قسمة ونصيب خوفت بدمي خلي فرشوها خوفت بدمي خوفت بدمي خلي فرشوها حنتي حنتي دمي والجيف انذار التراب يوم ذكريني من تمر زفة شباب الله يوم أصبح الدين شهيد وأفزع العام من يظل بالطف وحيد رملة بمصابي خلي واسوها رملة بمصابي رملة بمصابي خلي واسوها حنتي بصوتك حنتي دمي والجيف انذار التراب يوم ذكريني من تمر زفة أهلي وصاني بالوفا يوم الطفوف ومن دم وريدي يصبح خضاب شفوف وهذه وصيتي يلتسمعوها هذي وصيتي هذي وصيتي يلتسمعوها حنتي حنتي دايا يمي والجفن ذار التراب يما ذكريني تمر زفة شبا
خان I think he deserves another loud صلوات على محمد وآل محمد Wow
This qasida that I read is a big improvement comparing to the qasida I've read before. And I think the judges were very happy and inshallah I will get through to the finals.
How do you feel now?
Alhamdulillah, I feel blessed because I read this qasida.
Yeah?
Because it's very hazina and like I felt like everybody some people were crying as well. Yeah, and I feel like Alhamdulillah, afu muwaffaq, alhamdulillah.
Brilliant. Tawfiq, Mulla Nazar. Sant. We'll go to Sayyid Jalal.
Yusuf, or we can say Yuz Arsiv. MashaAllah. Beautiful recitation. Beautiful garment. Flexible voice you have. Soothing voice you have. You took the hearts of all mu'mineen to Karbala and it was really excellent recitation. You're reciting, actually it's shura, it's bayat shuri, mashallah, beautiful. But sometimes it was a little bit slow, sometimes fast. It is the nawha like this or you did? It's like this. Good. So that's, good. One point, and just that is, your voice is nasal. Of course, your voice is mature till now. It's not actually, because you are in the very critical age, but it will be sorted. Try to recite more from your chest. Practice this. Okay? Thank you very much. Ahsantum.
Sayyid Jalal. Mulla Nazar, you ready?
Bravo, Yusuf. I knew you and I knew what you like. So I believe that what I chose for you was good.
Yeah.
I mean, it was very compatible to you, especially that you are talking about Qasim ibn al-Hasan. And he was very young. He was very young. He was maybe 13 to 12 years old. And you recited very well. Yeah, maybe the speed was, it was a bit slow, yeah, but it was very good. And you played somewhere, you did Urab, very beautiful Urab you did, even better than the original one. I listened to the original one. Some places you changed, you played in Urab better than original one. You touched our heart. You touched our heart.
Ahmallah waldek. Ahmallah waldek.
Ahsanta mulla. Sayyid Mason, before we go to Dr. Sayyid Ammar. Sayyid Mason, please, last thoughts.
Yeah. So before you began, Sayyid Ammar, you know, leaned over and he said, you want to listen to this one? Almost everyone knows this. Let me. And to see, I turned around and looked at the crowd and wanted to see what kind of impact you were making on them. I saw tears on the majority of the people that were here. Partly because I think the Noha selection was so good. Because your age, as Mulla Nazar said, was very close. It's very relatable to Hazrat Qasim alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why people felt it a lot more. And I wanted to add, just because a Noha is slow doesn't mean that it's maybe easier. Actually, I think it's the opposite. I think it's harder because now you're challenged to show how much breath you can hold. And I think it's easy to lose your breath, and you sustained your notes incredibly. Perfect amount of vibrato, perfect pitch, everything. I felt that, even though I don't understand the language, I felt the grief. MashaAllah.
Thanks so much.
Well done. Thank you, Sayyid Maysim. And lastly, Dr. Sayyid Ammar.
Yusuf, all I can tell you is welcome to the service of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. You're well on that path, and I think you felt that spark that many of us felt at one moment. And that was when you see tears trickling from the eyes of those in front of you. You may lose everything in this world, but if you are able to make someone cry for Aba Abdullah, then you are the wealthiest person in the world. At this moment, on the stage you're at, you should be content because you've got many tears from the people here and inshallah, many lovers as well. Well done.
I sent him. Last thoughts to the audience, last thoughts to the viewers, last thoughts to the judges.
Yeah, I just want to say something. Even though I don't win the £10,000, I came here just to Akhdim al-Hussein. So that's all I care about.
Ahsant.
So even though I don't win,
and even a soft heart as well. Ahsant. Ladies and gentlemen, please, in memory of the person, the reciter that actually came forth with this qasida, in memory of Qasim ibn Hassan, salla ala Muhammadin wa Ali Muhammad.
Please don't tell me.
How do you feel like it went?
Alhamdulillah, it went good. Alhamdulillah, I felt confident.
Out of 10?
I felt like it went 9 out of 10.
MashaAllah. You know, making people cry, this is service of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. So well done, because that's what you achieved. In terms of what you can improve and the feedback, do you feel like you can take that on board and improve accordingly?
Yeah, a bit, yeah.
Have you done enough to get to the final though?
Inshallah, I have, inshallah. Inshallah, we'll see what they say.
Also, just wondering, you changed your qasida, you changed your track near the end. How come?
So, at home, I was reading Hada Hadi Dha'ina qasida. I felt like it wasn't really my type of qasida. So then after, I read Yom Dhikrayni and I felt like it was more hazin in my voice, and I felt like it made me like very sad from the inside as well, and I felt like it will make other people cry as well, and they did.
That's what we.
Alhamdulillah.
May Allah reward.
Allah wafakni bihal
qasida. You did amazing. Keep up the good work. Thank you, Sayyid.
Thanks so much.